guys, welcome to PC Tips Pro. This is Shreeja over here, and in today's video we're gonna see how to add table of contents in WordPress. So before getting into the video, if you guys haven't yet subscribed to the PC Tips Pro, please do subscribe. So now let's get into the video. So here we go guys. If your visitors want to read any content on your page, they need to scroll down, right? Like let's see our site here. So if you see, so this is my site over here. So when you see, if your users want to want to go to some of the sections, so they need to scroll down like this. So instead of scrolling like this, you can add contents on your page. Like when someone visits your site, they'll be able to go to a specific section of your website by selecting the topic. So now let's get into the video. So we'll add this table of contents in few steps. So our first step will be installing the plugin. So to install the plugin, let's go to the dashboard, WordPress dashboard. And now if you go to this plugins and search for and click for add new plugin. So now let's search for a plugin called as Easy Table of Contents. So when you click when you search for Easy Table of Contents, you get some plugins over here. So you see this Easy Table of Contents plugin. So to install this plugin, click on install now. So once it get installed, click on activate. So once you activate this, now the plugin is installed and activated. Now our second step. So our second step is where you want to add your table of contents on your page. So we'll go to now second step now. So once we are done with installing the plugin, we'll go to the second step, that is, which I have already told you, that choosing where we want to add our table of contents. So for that, go to the settings, and in the settings you can find this option called as table of contents. Click on it, and now you can choose where you want to place your table of contents. So for this, I choose posts. So I want to show my table of contents in this post. And now check this post, and then you can scroll down and click on save changes. So once this changes are saved, now go to the post and click on all posts. And now I want to select this my first post, and here to this post I want to add my table of contents. So when you go to this post, you can find this section below, that is the table of contents section. So initially it will look something like this. So you need to check this insert table of contents, and you can check this and click on update. So once it is updated, then the table of contents is added to your post called as Hello World. So in this step we have seen how can we add your table of contents to one post. But what if you want to add them to all the posts which are here, which are on your website? We'll see it now. So without adding this table of contents to each of the posts one by one, again and again, we can add to all of the posts at the same time, like automatically. So to do this, we'll go to the settings and go to the table of contents. And here you can find this auto insert option. So click on this, check this post section, and click on save changes. So once the changes are saved on your site, then all the posts are inserted by the with the table of contents now. So now we will see how can you remove this table of content from the single or one post exceptionally. Like if you want to add it to all the posts and want to remove only from one of the posts or among all your posts, how can you do it? So now we'll see. So to do it, let's go back to our settings and our table of contents. And then when you scroll down, you can find a section or an option called as limit path. So in this limit path, once we go to our post, let's go back to our post. So when we go back to our post, so here you can see that like an extension of your post, like with the slash. So this is my post name, Hello World, and with the slashes, copy this post. Copy this text. So once you copy this text, get back to our WordPress dashboard. So when you get back to this WordPress dashboard, and let's go back to our settings and table of contents. So here, well, let's go back to our limit path. So here, just paste it, like which post you want to remove this table of contents from. So just paste it and click on save changes. So when you paste it, the table of contents from that post are being removed. So now we will see how can you remove a heading from the table of contents. Now let's go to our post. So let's go to our post and let's see how can we exclude a heading from the post. So this is my post. So once we get to this post, we have several headings which are included in the table of contents. So just you have a heading for this headings. So just select the heading and click and just paste here in the exclude heading section. So if your heading is like, if my heading is something like specifications, that is my heading. So just type it or paste it over here and click on update. So once you update it, then the specifications heading is being removed from the table of contents. So now we will see how can we add table of contents to the sidebar, that is like this in the side. How can we add our table of contents to the sidebar? So for that, we'll go back to our WordPress dashboard. And once we go to this WordPress dashboard, go to the appearances. In the appearances, select widgets. So now you have this sidebar section here. So in this sidebar section, you just find this table of contents in this here you go. So drag this table of contents and then just add it in this sidebar and give it a title to be, I'll just give it to be some contents. So this is my title and click on save. So by this, your table of contents will be added to your sidebar. And if you want to remove it from the post, you can just go back to your settings and table of contents, settings of table of contents, and you can just uncheck this post section if you don't want to have at the both sides. Like, you will get it on the sidebar and also you'll get it on the post. If you don't want in the both places, you can just disable with the post. And now we will see how can you fix the sidebar moving along with your scroll bar. So we'll see it now. So now to fix the sidebar, we need to install a plugin. So go to the plugins and click on add new plugin. Now search for fixed widgets. So let's search for this. So you can see this plugin over here. So click on install now to install this plugin. So once the plugin is installed, click on activate. So when it is activated, and now it's activated. So now let's go back to the appearances. Yes, so let's go back to the appearances, and in the appearances, go for widgets. So here, go to the table of contents which you have added previously, and just check on this fixed widget and click on save. So that your sidebar is fixed. So this is all for this video, guys. I hope you found this video useful to you. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the PC Tips Pro. Thank you for watching, guys.